In this illustration, we'll analyze a chain falling on a table. We are given that a chain of mass m and length l hangs on a thread and its bottom end touches the surface of a table. At an instant, thread is burned and the part of falling chain on table does not bounce. We are required to prove that a force exerted on table by falling part of chain at any moment is twice the force exerted by resting part on the table. So, here in this situation, if we see the chain which is falling on the table and say it has fallen by a distance x from its initial height, and the length of chain which is resting on table is of height x, then as chain is in free fall, we can say its velocity is root 2gx, and we can calculate the weight of chain length resting on table after falling distance x is, this can be written as W1, which is equals to m by l multiplied by x is the mass of the chain resting on the table multiplied by g. So, this is the weight which will develop a normal reaction N1 on the table. The value of N1 is equals to this W1. And if we talk about the falling part of chain, and if we consider a small elemental length dx just above the table, so here we can write in a time dt, the momentum in elemental length dx of chain is imparted to table, because we are given that the table, on the table when a part of chain strikes, it does not bounce. That means the momentum contained in this dx length will be imparted to table after falling. So, this momentum dp which is there in the dx element is m by l multiplied by dx multiplied by v. So, this is the momentum of this elemental length dx. So, we can write the force exerted by this element, which falls on table in time dt, is this force can be written as dp by dt, as in time dt it imparts a momentum dp. So, this can be written as mv by l multiplied by dx by dt, which can be written as mv square by l. And if we substitute the value of v square, this 2gx, so this 2mgx upon l. And here we can see this force which the falling part of chain is imparting on table, that is f, this is equal to twice the n1, where n1 is the force which resting part of chain is imparting. So, this was what we are required to prove. So, we can write it hence prove. So, this is the way we can calculate a moving chain whenever a strike a surface from where it is not bouncing. The amount of force exerted can be calculated by using this method.